Doctor Demento.
On KMET Los Angeles. With Devo. And I have a letter here on the Dr. Demento Show from Ohio, a wonderful place and a state of mind long associated with de-evolution. And it says, Dear Dr. Demento, I am a rad skateboarder from Columbus, Ohio, and since I started skating, I've learned to crave new wave, especially the music of Devo. And since I love your show, the greatest thing in the world would be an interview with the Spud Boys themselves, signed a demented skater from Apple Skate Park, Marty Weil. Well, Marty, you got your wish, because here with us under the smogberry trees is the infantile spirit of de-evolution, Booji Boy. Welcome to Dementia, Booji Boy.
Salutations, beautiful mutants.
Thank you. And that song, Whip It, that is certainly one of the most popular songs in the land of dementia as well as the rest of the world these days. What does that song mean to you, Booji Boy?
Well, Whip It is one that everybody kind of gets their own meaning out of. I thought it was just kind of like a song of moral uplift, of people coming together and getting rid of their problems.
We sure need a lot more of those.
Do tell, Doctor.
Yes, indeed. And you brought a lot of very unusual records. I mean, even some records that I've never seen before.
Oh, good.
And we brought a little phonograph for you to play them on for us, too.
Oh, okay.
So, Booji Boy, you get to be a disc jockey.
That sounds like fun, Doctor.
Okay, you want to play us a record?
Let's go.
Okay. What's this first one going to be?
This one's by a guy from Germany named Holger Hiller.
All right. What's the name of this one?
This one's called Morgan Latte.
That sure was pleasant there. Booji Boy, that was beautiful. You found that record in Germany, huh?
Yeah, this guy Holger, he does a lot of stuff like that.
Yeah, that sounds a little like Devo in a way.
Oh, you know, it's those corkscrews going on in the brain. Similar.
You spend a lot of time in Germany, eh?
Yeah, we go all over the planet.
And you've been to France, too.
Oh, yeah.
Because this looks like a French record that you have ready for us here.
Yeah, a lot of these songs are off of either tapes or records that kids gave me when we were touring. And most of them never really ever made it, you know, out in public, you know, out in the light of day. But this one's by some real interesting little kids. They were about this big. I like music by little people. And they thought they were Japanese, but they're French kids. And this song's called Toco Boys. I don't know who did it, but they're from France. That's Toco Boys by, I don't really know who, because, they spoke French, and I didn't speak French. I spoke English, and so there's nothing written on the label or anything. Just somebody wrote with a pencil, Toco Boys.
Well, that sure is an interesting record there. You sure have advanced taste for a little baby there, Booji Boy.
Well, every time I listen to that one, it makes my point get hot, so I figured I'd bring it along.
Well, I guess hanging around with those Spud Boys, you do get to have rather advanced tastes in music.
Yeah, those guys, they get to a lot of different places.
And speaking of Devo, I see their name on this next little piece of tape here.
Well, this one, some people think it's the Quivering Cocoa Butts, and some think it's Devo, and I'm not really sure, but this is just obviously some basement tape. It's called Coalmine. Thank you.
day for the sun. When my work day is over, I'm too tired for having fun. Working in a coal mine, going down, down. Working in a coal mine, woo! About to step down. Working in a coal mine, going down, down. Working in a coal mine, woo! About to slip down.
Devolving in a coal mine on the Dr. Demento Show, that rare tape from the collection of Boogie Boy, who's here with us under the smogberry trees.
Hi, Doctor.
That was beautiful. Love that soul music, Boogie Boy. What else do you have for us from your record collection?
Here's one from Japan, from a band called The Plastics. This is a song called Copy.
Okay.
They sing in English.
The Plastics with Copy on the Dr. Demento Show from Boogie Boy's record collection. And we're here with the infantile spirit of de-evolution. Were there some babies singing on that record, Boogie Boy, like you?
Nope. They're just real little people. I think the biggest one weighed about 86 pounds. They were pretty nice. Toshi, the singer, he took me for a ride on his motorbike all over Tokyo once.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Only 86 pounds.
Yeah.
They don't eat enough potatoes over there.
No potatoes.
Well, thank you, Barnes and Barnes, for your music there. I'm Dr. Demento, and we're under the smogberry trees with the infantile spirit of de-evolution, Boogie Boy, who's playing us some wondrously devolved records and tapes from his personal playpen collection. Boogie Boy, what's next?
Well, Doctor, I'll tell you. This is one that I really like. This is an old one by Devo that never got on an official record. This one, it's been bootlegged a couple times, but I liked it enough, I thought we should use it. It was written in a time when Devo used to do things to me. I don't know if you ever saw any of our movies, but this was when I had to spend 6 weeks in a brown rubber bag on a playpen and down in the rehearsal area. And this song I heard maybe 400 times or so during that 6 weeks, and I came to love it. It's called I'm a Potato, and I'm So Hip.
Bye. doubted, the illusion, self-execution, no solution. I'm a smut gun, I like to shoot a wall.
I'm a Potato, rare music from Devo on the Dr. Demento Show, where we're here with Boogie Boy. Do you ever get mad at those guys because they keep you in that playpen and they only let you sing at the end of the show and all that?
Yeah, they do tricks to me all the time.
Like what?
Well, they tricked me into going in the toaster for my toast, and they left it plugged in. They talked me into putting my head underneath a tire press once.
Really?
Yeah.
What happened? What happened to you?
It flattened my head. It was only this wide for a long time.
That must have hurt because it only looks like an inch wide there.
That was only about an inch wide.
Tell me one thing about the fellows in Devo. Do they ever smoke?
Oh, no.
They never smoke at all?
They smoke nothing.
Well, if they did smoke, I think we know the kind of cigarette that they would smoke.
If a cold has taken the edge off your smoking enjoyment, you want Spuds. The mentholated cigarettes that keep your mouth fresh as a daisy, your head clear as a bell. Spuds are gently mentholated. So remember, when you want a refreshing change from your regular smoke or a soothing menthol cigarette to comfort a cold, freshen up with Spuds. Spuds keep your mouth fresh as a daisy, your head clear as a bell.
Well, the music of Devo is certainly clear as a bell.
Spuds cigarettes! Who would have imagined, huh?
I don't think they make those anymore, and it's too bad.
I think anybody who smokes them are spuds anyhow.
Yeah, well, it's much better than tobacco, I suppose, smoking potatoes.
Yeah.